I am him, not them.
I'm seeing numbers, I must be the one. Rain man, yeah, they think that I'm gone. I don't care, let them think what they want. I'm doing it for them, I do it for funds. To buy away in cause of arm and the leg. So I run it up like the money upstairs. I'm just getting started, I hope they prepared. They counting me out, so they counting me in.
I am him, not. Yes, 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 man. Look, tonight is an exclusive night. You already know who it is. It's Mr. Pringles the Barber, a.k.a. Alwayzkuttn's head honcho. I am him, not them. I am him, not them. In the building tonight, we have the marvelous, the magnificent Mr. It's Just Different. Man, look, man, in the building, we got Columbus's own Kase Kuttz. Kase.
Yeah, man.
What's happening? And before Kase go on in, I can't forget my special co-host, the comedian Teddy Williams. Make sure y'all go follow Teddy, man. What is it? Hey,
Teddy the comedian.
Hey, Teddy the comedian. Yeah. Hey, man, we about to get it in, man. We've been waiting for this highly acclaimed interview with Kase Kuttz, man. You know, Kase always ready to talk some shit. So let's go ahead, get this in there. Let's get this going, man.
Yeah.
What's happening? How the day been?
Man, it's been good today, man. You know, every day is a good day, though.
Damn right.
I don't believe in bad days, man. I don't believe in that, man.
Right.
You wake up, man. I woke up. It's a beautiful day. It's a good day, man.
You're right. So if you had an okay day the day before, can wake up and have a better day.
Right. Mm-hmm. I don't have okay days, though. Every day is great.
You never had a bad day?
I wake up.
You ain't never Friend, had.
I wake up. You feel me? I got woke up, man. You know, it took me a minute to come to that in life, but you know what I mean? Once I start understanding, like, man.
It's about perspective on how you look at a situation. You can find something good out of everything.
It's a new opportunity.
Man, what the
man,
hell?
Man, this nigga,
who
man.
Is that? Oh.
That's Lil Rel. That's who this nigga look like.
Hey, looking like Lil Rel.
He looks dead on Lil Rel. And he's got his gun next to me.
Man, who is Lil Rel?
So Lil Rel, he's a comedian. He was in Get Out. He was a black guy in Get Out. Man. If anybody remembers the movie Get Out, he's the black guy. Actually, was Kase.
Lil Rel. Hey, y'all, that's gonna pop up on the screen, man. Y'all will see that some other time. We're gonna make sure y'all see Lil Rel.
I'm about
man.
To be laughing all the time. Let me put it
away. We're gonna see.
He's got good
about.
Days.
great
so, days.
So, Kase, man, how long you been cutting? How long you been a barber? Like, how long you been, a, you know what I mean, branded barber?
Branded?
Yeah, doing your thing that way.
It's been about 11.
11 years?
Yeah.
So when you get out of barber school?
Shit.
I got out in 2010, 2009, 2010.
Like 11, 12.
So you came the year after I got out?
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah. You was there the year right after I got out.
I came straight from that thing.
I did too.
Yeah.
What year you get out?
Straight.
What year you get out?
Like 11.
Oh, you got out in 11?
Yeah.
I got out in 07.
I got out at the beginning of 11.
Okay.
I came straight to, and yeah. I never missed a day of school, never
Power
missed
move.
An hour, never missed, you know, just already had it up here. What was, you know,
See,
it wasn't about
just,
if this worked.
Out.
It's like this shit got
Which,
to
you
work.
You drink Henny or you drink tequila? Which one you be on? You gonna say this, DeLeon?
DeLeon.
Yeah, I'll take a top shelf
barber.
No, not even that. I really ain't been drinking, but
we're gonna have this ain't drink champs, but we got champions in the building. You know what I'm saying?
I'm the mimosa nigga. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah,
I'm
man.
I'm
he introduced me to nigga. Some whole other shit. I hadn't had no mimosas. Yeah, man.
I'm the mimosa nigga. I know my lane.
So how long you end up doing in there?
Oh.
There you go. This one over there. It's right there.
It was a nice little 2-6.
It's a shell. Turn it on the back. You can see what it is. It's a 50 cal. It already been used.
Oh, okay,
be careful.
Okay.
There's no fingerprints on there.
Oh, okay. Right. Okay. I've done a little thing.
I'm saved.
Thing. I've done a little something up in there, though, man. It was, you know.
Yeah, I did a fireball, man.
Yeah. Round.
Yeah, you know. Yeah, in the same. Yeah.
It's the best. It was.
You never take it back.
Listen.
Yeah,
listen,
let me take it back.
I ain't gonna cap. Like, when I first came home, I used to feel like embarrassed. Not I don't know if you want to call it embarrassed. Like, you know, you don't want to talk about it. You don't want to.
Nah, you gotta talk about it.
I realized, you know, not too much later on, but I realized, like, man, that was the best thing that ever happened to me.
Bro. Yeah, saved your life.
Cause I was there.
I
was there, bro.
That's usually like, when it catches
on a, but it gave me time to really sit with myself and analyze myself. You know what I'm saying? Like with the hustle and bustle out here, the world and every day, you don't really get that. You know what I'm saying? Not on that level.
You got too many distractions out here.
Exactly.
It's just you.
I really had to sit with myself and be like, you bullshit on this. You know what I mean? You slacking on this. You could have done this, that, different. Like, just basically, you know, chastising myself in a way, but on a positive note, too. You know what I mean?
And you
gave me time to set goals, really, you know, be dedicated to it. And, you know, before that, I was in the military, though.
Oh, damn. In a sense, you was able to adjust a little bit better than somebody that ain't... Because you got boot camp when you go to the military, right?
Well, shit, yeah. Before boot camp, I was at home. At home was boot camp, so shit, it was all the... Yeah. You know what I mean? It was all the same thing, too. But, you know, you get up in there and you see so many people who literally have given up on life.
Yeah.
Like, they've given up. Like, it's over... You know, even the ones who get out, come back, get out, come out. Like, man, they ain't living. And I'm like, man, this ain't me. I just felt all the way out of place.
You
like,
do
I
feel out of, yeah.
I ain't supposed to be here.
Yeah, I ain't supposed to be here. But it's a lot of people in there that feel the same way. Because really, you notice that that's where all the talent at.
Yeah. Well, I think they forced to tap in, too.
Yeah.
Like how we was just talking about. But, yeah, it was the best thing that ever happened to me. And like I said, I've been... Well, you ain't asked the question, but I've been cutting hair since I was about 10 years old.
Yeah, see, I was
you know
about,
what I'm
yeah.
saying?
That's and about, that, about that. You started cutting your own hair first, didn't you?
Cut my own hair, my little brother.
Yeah, that's how I go. Yeah.
My sister's dolls, everything. Anything I could, you know what I'm saying? And I went to the military and I used to cut there. You know what I mean? Shout out all my brothers, you know what I'm saying? They still support me to this day.
Now, in the military?
Yeah, my military cast.
So like, when you was still, in the military, did they, wasn't that like murder ones?
Nah.
They let you fade? They let you fade out and all that?
Yeah.
That shit was crispy, regular, no edge-ups?
Regular, yeah.
Man, they ain't let you put no edge-ups on there in the
military. Yeah, hun, it wasn't basic training.
Yeah.
In basic training, that's murder one and all. But once you get, you know what I mean? Once you get to your station and all of that, now, you can't have facial hair and all of that. You know what I mean?
So but that was good on for you.
As far as the cuts, you know what I mean? But it was still, at that point, it was still a hobby.
Okay.
You know what I'm saying? It was just something that I never seen myself doing this for, like, you know what I mean? Then I got locked up. I got locked up. And I didn't even have a license. You locked up, you supposed to have your
license to cut in the shop.
Right.
Yeah, yeah.
So one of the administrators, I was cutting in the dorm. You know, niggas that didn't have no money to go to the barbershop. Da, da, da.
That's why I was cutting. I was cutting in the dorm with the razor. Yeah, yeah.
Boom.
Yeah.
He was like, you nice. He was like, da, da. He's like, you got your license? I'm like, nah. He's like, I'm going to see what I could do for you. Da, da. So he got me in the barbershop.
Yo, now. You was in a sweet spot. Where was you at?
Now, what... Cats don't understand. I'm going to get...
Yeah.
Dude just told me yesterday, I seen one of the young dudes from the barber school. And he's still out here doing this thing. You know, I asked him, like, you finished school? And he like, nah. I'm still working on it. He's like, man, every time I'm... Streets be calling, man. I got to get back. I said, well, go get them license. I was like, because... And you end up there, you gonna need that.
They don't understand that. That right there is this right here, too. It's all the same thing. The cut is dope, too. It's all the same. That's how I look at it.
It is. But I guess I could see where they at. You know what I'm saying? It's going hard head, make it soft ass. But I'm like, you gonna need that, bro. Because when you get up in there, you know, I was rich in that motherfucker. You know what I'm saying? I was a barber. I was good. You know what I'm saying? You know, you ain't got to call home and ask for too much or nothing like that. You know.
The reason I say it is because before I wouldn't have said it. When you know everybody was running around, they didn't have social media and all that shit. And, you know, cuts $15, $20. Man, now as a barber with all the social media platforms and all that going on, the money that
there's
you can
no
make,
way.
Yeah, you. It's no reason that you should. I was in the streets. I did that shit, you know. But when I balance it out and look at it, like, for what you can do now, being a barber,
I'm not gonna cap. I was making way more money on that, but I'm comfortable where I'm content to where I ain't got. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. I'm cool on that. You know what I'm saying? That's a whole nother story, though.
But look at it. Look at this, though. I mean, the reason I'm talking about this is because I look at it like for the youngins, like you were just talking about, dude. Some niggas, they just stuck in between. They don't know which way to go. So the best thing, the best avenue I can say that's relatable to that is being a barber. You control your time. Your phone gonna ring the same way.
Yeah,
everything is the same. It's the same.
I hit that door.
Yeah, it's the same thing.
Yeah.
Now, as far as making the money, how long can you make the money without a fumble? Every time you fumble, think of it like this. So say he out in the streets. He eating. Same way. You the barber. You still the same barber you are today.
Right.
If he fumble and he get locked up for 4 or 5 years,
right,
you still going to be eating by time he get out.
Right.
You're going to be that made more money than he made.
Right.
So it's a marathon.
It is. And I mean, we live in it's the microwave generation. Everybody want
they want to,
you know, instant gratification and everything, do something for them.
They want to stay.
You know what I'm saying? There's no work involved in it. You know what I'm saying? But I felt the best. I tell all my clients, like, I would never trade this ever, bro. Like, I felt the best ever. The sense of accomplishment that come with it. The sense of, you know what I mean? You go from having to look over your back and da-da-da.
Yeah.
And just not even having to do that. Like,
that's a big that's like lifted, 75% like, of it. Man.
But what's so crazy is, now, it ain't no rules to the game. So you do kind of got to kind of watch your back. You know what I'm saying? Like,
you ain't got to watch your back from the boys, though.
That, right.
You know, when you go, when you in the street and you got to go grab that or do this or worry about this, that, you got to worry about that rear view mirror. If I get caught, he done crossed, he it's just too many. Man.
I still, I don't know what you want to call it. Not, I guess you call it street institutionalized. But I still be, I told a client one day, he looked at me crazy. I said, he was late. And I was like, nigga, if this was a deal, you be dead, bro. This would be awesome. But same rule, you know what I mean?
The same rules apply.
Yeah,
the same rules apply.
Charge
your phone. Oh, man, they don't want to do that. Yeah, it's all good. This ain't even going to be up that long. Y'all going to have to go to Alwayzkuttn Barber Talk to see the rest of this interview anyway. what's that? Yeah, that's just for the youngins, man. It's another side to the streets, man. I just say,
I can't do it.
No, man.
I can't do it. I've been in positions where,
it's crazy
because, I mean, when I got out, it helped me filter out a lot of people who wasn't, you know what I mean? They just knew, like, you know what I mean? And everybody was quick to try to throw you this, throw you that, this, that. And I'm like, nah, I'm about to do this barber and shit. And niggas was like, what?
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? You ever seen that thing? Nigga, all this money out here.
Yeah, what is you doing? Like, you done bumped your head when you went there. Yeah.
You know, I ain't no super religious person. I'm more of a spiritual person, excuse me. But I felt like God just filtering. You gotta go. Yep, that's one you gotta get away from. You know what I'm saying? And shit, the chicks, everything, all that shit that came with that street shit just filtered on out. Get on up out of, you know what I'm saying?
Put your mic closer to you.
And I went through a struggle period kind of after that. You know what I'm saying? It was a struggle getting through school kind of. It was that pressure of worrying about other people. You know, he ain't that nigga. Look, he, you know what I mean? Look what he driving. Look what he wearing. I went through all of that.
You got to rebuild. You got to tear down.
Yeah, because before I got locked up, my phone was off the... Hey, nigga, we here tonight. This, that, let's go. No calls. Why no calls? No invites. No nothing. I was feeling the way like, damn, they don't... You know what I'm saying? You know what I mean? I needed $20-$30 here and there. Niggas was like, man, I'm like, wow.
You got to see the real. That's the real. That's what you need to see, though. That's what you need to see, though.
Yeah, and I just got up from around. I told somebody else, I said, that's the hardest shit I ever had to do, bro.
Yeah.
So I kind of understand how niggas get out and the pressure of all that shit take them back to what they was doing. But at the same time, it take a stronger person, bro. It takes some type of strength to say, cold turkey, fuck that shit. You know what I mean? And I just got a little
It's easier to go and do the same shit than it is to turn around and evolve.
Right.
That's what make you the man.
You already know. I came home with that bag, nigga. Garbage bag. And,
I know.
Had to get new drawers, socks.
Yeah, when they crack that gate, the sun shine different. You be like, man. What? It's like being born again.
And you know, the first couple of weeks is cool and everybody, and then after that, it's like.
Yeah, you back in the world. It's real.
What the fuck about to happen, man?
Let's go with this, man. So, what was you thinking about the, what you thinking about this Barber versus, man? The Barber versus here. Did you get to check the one out with Keith Kuttz and Wood Folk the Barber?
I did. I watched it on the Alwayzkuttn.
On the YouTube?
Yeah.
What do you think about the Barber versus? As far as the culture for, you know, Columbus, like, my thing of doing it is just to bring us together. Like, it's like, because everything's so divided. Here, I don't think, like, in a lot of spots, like, you can say, like, Atlanta, Florida. Them barbers out there, they stick together. They stick together way more than here.
You do. You got the same shit everywhere. Just like you got people be like, oh, fuck niggas in Columbus. It's fuck niggas in Cleveland and Florida, too. It's there. You know, and sometimes us seeing it from
a distance,
you know, just like I thought Philly. I used to look at the Philly barbers and be like, damn, them niggas all. And now I talk to Philly niggas and they be like, nah, niggas don't be. You know what I'm saying? Like,
I don't really see. I really don't see from where I'm looking at. I don't really see a whole bunch of Philly barbers sticking together. When I look at what I mean by sticking together, like say like Tune 45.
Well, that's that's a whole nother. You want to get into that?
We can get into it. We're here.
Okay. I feel like, and I see just like hip hop.
Yeah.
I see the culture being taken away from us. Same way. I see the culture being taken from us the same way. And, you know, I'm that nigga who be at the show saying this shit. And niggas be looking like.
Yeah, we like, already got insight about you. You already told me you was well educated when it comes to the barber. You know who the first barber was.
And I don't give a fuck. You know what I'm saying? Like, I ain't into. This is art. This is way more than just cutting hair to me. Like, anybody will be able to know that I take this shit serious. You know what I'm saying? Like, Erykah Badu said, I'm an artist and I'm sensitive about my shit. Like, I'm sensitive about the whole culture of it. You know what I mean? But. Like I said, I'm watching this shit being taken away from us. I go to shows. I watch. I can't give you that high. I see barbers that are scared to compete or scared to put their work out there because they don't have somebody with straight hair. You feel me? Because they feel like this is the standard for this and I have to do this or else. And they already feel a bias like, well, I'm not Latino, or I'm not this, or I'm not that. You know what I'm saying? It's like, what? Our haircuts ain't dope no more? Like, I don't see us winning no more. I don't see us being put on them stages. And it's because they creating their own thing over here.
So what do you get out of Tune 45 as far as snatching it away? Because it's not just...
No, I like what they're doing.
It's some of us affiliated with that.
It's not nothing against us. It's our fault. You know what I'm saying? It's our fault for not coming together, not taking it serious, using it as side hustles and this on it. You know what I mean? Like, I absolutely hate when somebody tell me, I respect your hustle. Nah, my nigga, this ain't no hustle, bro.
This ain't no hustle,
Explain bro.
Explain that, because somebody called me on that at a barber. What's the difference? This is not, what's a hustle versus what we doing?
I'm hustling because I'm grinding.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? In a sense, but... This is not a hustle. This is not a hobby for me.
No.
This is not, you know
this
what I mean? When
craft.
You say that, it makes it seem
craft.
Like it's a hobby or it's something real quick or something. I do it on the side. And when you, I believe that it's power in words.
You're
so
right.
When I let people get away with that
belittle
shit,
my
that's
whole,
how they're
yeah,
going to feel
yeah,
about
yeah.
it. You know what I'm saying? So any of my clients, anybody ever been to me, they'll tell you, I got standards, bro. You got standards for me that I need to uphold. And I have standards for you. You know what I'm saying? First and foremost, the number one is going to be respect. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? My time equals respect. Universally, time equals respect. You waste somebody's time, that's disrespect,
bro. That's more important than money.
That's more important than money.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? So that's how I feel on that. I just see the culture being snatched. And it's our fault. And we need to grab it back, bro.
Where do you feel like Tune 45 is snatching the culture? Like, it's
no, I'm not saying. I'm not necessarily saying Tune 45. I know them cats. I know Basio.
Basio. And,
you know what I'm saying?
It's a few
and
of them.
They cool cats. They doing what they're supposed to do.
Yeah.
They're doing what we're supposed to be doing.
That's
but
what I was saying.
There is some times where I feel like they're cutting us out of it, too. You know what I'm saying? When you see me, I used to, when I cut, show my clippers, show certain.
Yeah, yeah.
None of that no more. No. I'm not giving no free
sponsorship.
No, none of that. No. Yeah. Now, if you want to, Jermaine Walker, I'm going to show that. You know what I'm saying?
OG.
That's my brother. I'm going to show, you know what I mean? Certain people like that, I'm showing that, but I'm not giving
them
nobody
fire.
Else.
Them products are smoking, ain't they?
My God. You already know.
Yeah, I
be trying to figure out. I don't know what that nigga doing putting in that shit. Nigga, I don't read the whole. I don't went through the bottom ingredients. I said, damn.
Yeah.
He got a cold blooded one. But at the same time, we gotta support that.
Yeah.
Because that's our brother. We gotta support that. We gotta support that. How they supporting Elegance? How they supporting Tune 45?
Shout out to OG Walker. Shout out to OG Walker.
Almost
yeah.
definitely.
Yeah.
That's my guy. He funny as hell too.
Yeah,
Morano.
Morano.
Doc. I can't see his name. Ooh. My bad, bro. You know who I'm talking about. You work with Morano. Doc. I get it.
It'll come. Shout out to him. Either way it go, you already know.
I'm
just saying, like, for them to build what they are building, like if I didn't have this platform, it wouldn't be like, you see how I can just call you up,
right?
It's just to have a platform to build is the network, like
right.
Okay, so now everybody that come through here, it's like a phone call away now. You know what I mean?
It's a small, what's the name of us growing?
Yeah,
but what I find, a lot of these niggas, they just don't believe. They just don't believe, bro. Like, and they don't believe. Quick story. When I was starting the show, when I was starting the Ohio State Barber Expo, I was asking people, like, you know, I need help. Come in. I didn't really need help, but I needed help because, and people was like, I got you. You know what I mean? I'm like, no. I want you to invest in it because... When you invest in it, you're invested in it. You're going to work harder. You're going to
talk
you,
about
you
that
have,
shit.
You got it on the table, just like I got it on the table. And that's all. That's all I was trying to do. And it was people bullshitting with that. I literally and everybody, everybody. When you gonna do another one? When you gonna man? That shit hard. And we seen people try to do it, and they
that shit gonna be easy next time. It's like, gonna be a little bit easier.
Oh,
next
it got
time.
Easier every time.
It's about to be a lot easier.
But I was doing literally everything, bro. From booking the people who came, the backdrops, designing them. Any commercial you seen on there, you gotta edit this this video. So you understand, I'm going through hours and hours of editing. I'm on social media all night. You know what I'm saying? Because I gotta get the people on the East Coast, on the West Coast. I gotta make sure, you know, I'm trying to get everybody to come, and I'm trying to get the event out there like that. So it was a lot, bro. It took a heavy toll on me. So kind of the pandemic and stuff coming, it was lightweight, like, whew, good, like, man, you know what I'm saying? But then once everybody seen how that it was successful, and that's when people like, oh yeah, I want. And now I'm feeling away like, nah, bro.
Still, what people like, saying, nah. You can say a lot. A pair of lips will tell you anything.
Yeah, yeah, most definitely. So, but you know what I mean? Yeah. It's now y'all with it because y'all seen like, oh, he really done this shit. Like it really, you know what I'm saying? Like, yeah, bro, and it's profitable. You know what I mean? That helped. You know what I mean?
Look, check this out. We about to go to a quick break. You know, we about to get paid. Little commercials, man. No, big commercials. We don't use little on anything.
Okay.
So, we be right back with Kase Kuttz. Go ahead. Man, say that shit one time. Go ahead. Because I can't say it like you. So, you got to do it. Go ahead. Give it to him one time. Go ahead. One time. What?
Nah, I can't even do it, seriously.
We gonna get him to do it before we get up out of here. But we be right back with Kase Kuttz, y'all.
Hero. M.O.B., nigga. Hey, we done came a long way from hanging on that boulevard. We was shooting for the stars. Bro was out there pulling cars. We was trying to stay away, but it got hard, so we got involved. The streets was up for grabs and needed a name. So we made it ours. It was get down to lay down. You know the motto, nigga. Ain't no love, so you had to keep your feelings in a bottle, nigga. And them boys around you, they got shaky. Shit, that's how I be. You can put food on they plate, but you can't make them eat. You can shift their mind into that grind, but you can't make them think. You can even lead them to the lake, but they ain't gonna make them drink. When it's beast time, shit, you gotta be a beast. And when it's war inside your heart, it gets hard to deal with peace. Mama taught me to be good. Pops told me it was gravy. I went to church a few times, but Pastor Moore couldn't save me. Started banging as a youth, painting everything blue. And all those lies that they told us, we accepted as the truth. Niggas saying that they mob, sucker, you ain't mob yet. We was turning in your projects, we was turning up them projects. You gotta love it. I done wore this twice this week. You gotta thug it. Niggas ain't wanna make these moves, so nigga, fuck it. I'm riding around solo now. You know it's real when it's yourself that gotta hold you down. Damn. One time for my shy nigga. You told me keep that shit by your side, nigga. Hey. I ride for my niggas. I slide for my niggas. Pride to the side for my niggas. Yeah, yeah. I ride for my niggas. I slide for my niggas. Pride to the side for my niggas. Yeah, yeah. Now my mind and God elevated. I'm feeling groovy, I've been praying, shit, I'm highly favored. Yeah, it's been a while since I asked a favor. I need that Rollie presidential, I should run for mayor. Lord, homie talking crazy, I just kept a player. Been shaving onions since a pup, and we gon' hit some layers. No stepping to a boss, you gon' get the business. I knew it wasn't love, so I kept my distance.
Yeah. We back in the building with Kase Kuttz, man, and my, my special co-host, man, Teddy Williams, the comedian. We about to go ahead and get this back going again, man. I was going to make a phone call. Somebody told me to call him when she got in the building.
All right.
Yeah, we're going to make this phone call. Let me see if he, what he got going on. Let's see. See if he going to come up real quick.
Why you doing that? I'ma say, I'm away.
Yeah. We gonna see if he gonna pick up. What he got? Yo. Man, who? Hey, Is this custom auto the guy?
What's good?
What's happening, man? You know, we got Kase Kuttz in the building, man. I told him I was going to call you up real quick. How you doing over there? Cool. How you doing over there?
Chilling.
Smoking a cigar.
Yep, you already know. Up in here watching Monday Night Football, this cigar lounge, chilling.
Okay.
Man, you living a life of that, like life for real, man. Where you at? Well, you OT, right?
Yeah, I'm up in Dallas.
Man, that's love, man. We was just talking about how in the city, man, bringing everybody together, man, so we can build something, man. You know, it's a lot of, we was talking about the envy and shit in the city, you know, all that.
Yeah, I know. It's kind of like for no reason, though, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
Yeah, it's absolutely for no reason when you got a lot of neighborhood barbers being, you know, neighborhood heroes, you know what I'm saying? And it's like, you know, we can all build and live and create. Motherfuckers just want to be the king in their neighborhood, I guess.
Hey, let me tell you what this nigga done one day. This nigga called me, bro, and was like, bro, you got way more haters than me. This nigga always try to throw. Man, way more people hate you than me, bro. I'm like, nah, bro. You got it.
Listen, I'm going to keep it honest. From what I hear, what come through my ear, between you two, as far as the most hate, I'm going to just keep it all way 100. Can I get a drum roll? What the fuck is the drum roll? Like, I ain't got a drum roll. So listen, I ain't got a drum roll, but I'm going to just tell you, Kase, you got the most hate. He's right. Listen. Hey, for real, you got the most hate, bro. I'm trying to tell you, straightforward, you get the most hate in the city.
Know what's crazy, though?
What?
They don't know me. I don't go no... Where have you ever seen me, bro? Other than...
You know how we built on the...
But where have you...
Nah.
Can't nobody tell you where they see... Bro, I go to work and go home. Niggas don't see me nowhere. They don't even know me.
It's social media.
They know Instagram, bro.
It's social media.
Yeah. And let me tell you, when I first started this shit, I'm like... I understood, like, first of all, I'm not from here. Mm-hmm. I didn't go to school here. I didn't come up with nobody. So I got to build a clientele. I'm using the Ali approach, bro. That's all I said. I said, I'm going to use the Ali. Nigga, I'm pretty. You know what I'm saying? I'm going to get them here. My whole thing was to get them here in this chair.
Yeah.
And then, you know what I'm saying? Do my thing and hopefully I retain them. You know what I'm saying? Just get them here. Get them here and then, you know what I'm saying? So that was the tactic I used. I'm Ali. You know what I mean? I'm Lakota. I make
good. Hello, Pringles.
What's happening?
Pringles. It's just different.
Case.
You know what I'm saying?
Hey, man.
That's what he hit him with. Hit him with that shit. That smooth.
All right, that right there.
Now, hey, now look, though. Everybody got a punchline. Everybody got a, you know what I'm saying? I honestly feel like I've been doing that. And to keep it all the way 100, it ain't about being the best. No, none of that shit. It's a lot of talent. But I feel like I'm the most consistent nigga, and I have been ever since I started this shit. I feel like I've been the most consistent as far as product. You know what I'm saying? As far as social media, boom, 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 keeping going. That's how me and this nigga met. You know what I'm saying? Niggas gonna see me all the time.
But you gotta think about it like this, though. I was always told all publicity is good publicity.
Oh, most definitely.
So whether you get hated on, envy, jealousy, all that shit is wrapped up.
Let me tell you though,
work for you.
Them same cats, if they do catch me in Walmart, if they do catch me at the store, the gas station, what up, bro? I'm at the get with you, bro. Da 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 da. I can show you them same niggas in my DM. You know what I'm saying? I can show you them same cats in my DM. Hey man, you still got some more of that? Hey man, you da 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 da. Know what I'm saying?
That's what separates the hate from the envy. That's how you know it's envious versus being hated. Yeah. It's not actually being hated. It's just being you know, envy.
Because I ain't never came in between nobody's money, bro. I ain't out here. Y'all, I don't. I don't have an open sign, or you can't find nowhere on my page where I'm saying come let me cut your hair. I don't promote that, bro. I just put out the work. That's it. I don't cut kids. Damn, I left you all these lanes. Like, bro, shit, I'm just doing me. But, you right. know, it is what it is, man. It's funny to me.
Yeah, because we ain't going to hold you. I'm about to go ahead. Hey, we about to pull a case out here a little bit more. Hey.
Hey, get on him. Let him back. Let the case go.
I got him. I got him. I got him, man.
Take the chains off of him, man. Watch him go.
All right, man. Enjoy your trip, man. I'll holler at you when you get back in.
All right, bro.
Okay. Okay. All love, man.
All love, 100.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Yeah, man. Yeah, man. All publicity is good for bliss. You ain't.
Oh, most definitely. Yeah, bro. Yeah, I don't lose no sleep or be, you know, worried about nobody. If anything, bro, I've helped these same cats, you know, whether it was them coming from school, helping them with a cut, you know, if it was, you know, they won't admit it, man, but I've done it. I used to be any of these cats coming out of school. They'd be like, man, even when I graduated, I was still at school every day up until probably to the pandemic.
So when you was in school, because I want to touch on this.
Mm-hmm.
When you was in school, did they have enhancements?
No, it was just
common. It was just cuts, yeah.
Yeah. Shout out my guy, Cameo. Cameo up at, what is it? Barber Zone. He up at Barber Zone on Morris Road. But he was the first cat to ever show me Beijing, any of that. Even though I used Beijing one time. I don't use it now, but I'm saying that's the first thing that I was introduced to.
Mm-hmm.
Ever. He the one who showed me that shit. Other than that, no, there's a reason, bro. If you go to my page, I got about, I don't know how many followers, but I didn't buy none of them. You know mm-hmm. what I'm saying? I don't believe in that shit. If you follow my work, I want you to follow my work because yeah, you like my work.
Those grassroots followers, those and organic then, followers.
Yeah. Yeah.
You got 4,900. I'm on your page.
Okay,
right now.
There it is. 4,900. Yeah. But look, posts, 5,277.
Yeah.
And a lot of people erase their shit. I don't. You know why? Because when people start talking like that, I say scroll to the bottom, bro.
Growth.
And see the levels in the you know what I'm
elevation.
Saying?
Elevation, yeah.
Exactly, bro. It wasn't always like this. And to tell you the truth, right now I still don't feel like I'm doing nothing or enough.
So my question though is, as far as like the enhancement game, like,
mm-hmm.
do you use enhancements? Sometimes, mm-hmm. sometimes,
yeah,
okay.
Sometime.
All right. Because I see, this is what I'll be trying to tell younger barbers. The thing is for you to master the cut,
mm-hmm.
finish your cut, then you can throw some rims on the whip.
Man, I heard you talk about it with cuts, and it's the same way, bro. My goal is to, even when I enhance, my goal is to enhance and make it look as natural
as possible. Don't, oh, less but is best. Go ahead.
On my page, on the videos, you'll see me start from the blend, everything.
Yeah, yeah.
I'm telling them, like, I'm about to, boom, we see light right here. I'm going to hit that, da-da-da-da-da.
Yeah, yeah.
But it shows the cut. I had a guy on there the other day. He said, I saw the taper before you edged it up or anything, and I knew it was going to be fire. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm.
I know you talking about dude. Yeah, yeah, I seen that.
Because that's what you get to first. You know what I mean? The foundation has to be strong. Then you add the enhancements, and the haircut looks so much better.
Exactly.
And it ain't looking crazy.
And one thing about enhancements, me and mm-hmm. him talked about this with cuts too. Like he's saying, the cut lasts in 3 weeks. The objective is for when these enhancements wear off, you still have the cut.
Exactly. And that's the difference between quality. That's when that's when I see somebody's haircut and it might be 2-3 weeks old and I'll be like, okay. You know, because we train like that. We in the store at Kroger's, like,
yeah, you looking at everything.
You know what I'm saying? Like,
yeah.
Yeah.
You're right.
Yeah. Yeah, all right. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. Or you might be like, it's
you terrible. Always but this is the thing though, I can say a skilled barber. I don't care what cut you see. You'll always see something that you'll be like,
No, I see stuff in mine that I be like.
Yeah, when you go back and look at the video, because, like you look at a picture.
Because I am, just like we was just talking about haters and hate, can't nobody hate on me worse than me. Because I am my worst critic, bro. I am definitely, I have pictures, anybody I've ever cut, I have pictures of it from barber school, bro. Anybody I've ever cut, I can pull up pictures. Sometimes my clients, I'll send them pictures from 2011. Like, remember, we started here, bro. You know what I'm saying? Like, because I study that, and I study every barber. Every barber. All of y'all that be online, I ain't got time to go through. I like where I can like or what stuff I like. But
you do not like pictures like that, Kase. I'm going to give it to you straightforward.
I just said that.
No, you don't. Listen.
I just said that. But I study everybody, though.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? And sometimes I don't like shit because I don't like it.
Listen, this is what I noticed. What you do is you might not like a picture, but you'll be on the story. Mm-hmm. Like, you'll pop up on the story. But you might not like, you do like here and there, but you ain't, like when I'm scrolling on people's page, your name ain't gonna pop up.
Cause I just be scrolling, like, you know what I'm saying? But I look at everybody's shit, bro. I look at even new barbers, I don't care who it is.
Now,
I study everybody.
The reason why I like a picture, I might not actually like really be feeling the cut like that.
Mm-hmm.
But my like is more of, I understand how social media is set up is for. Like, it's almost like a release of dopamine.
Mm-hmm.
For barbers that's coming up, that's trying to grow, that simple like.
I'm getting inspired.
You feel what I'm saying?
I'm getting there, but I'm old, bro.
Older than you.
I don't think so.
I guarantee you I am.
Probably about a year.
Probably so.
but we come from the same.
Yeah, you know, we're the same
just
place.
Like, I had somebody tell me that, like, I thought we was beefing. You don't be liking. I was like, what?
See,
like, is y'all niggas that serious about this shit? Okay,
because that's what I'm saying. You got to look at it.
He going like, bro.
But that's
like,
what I'm saying. You got to look at it like this. It's almost like, you know, when you training a motherfucking dog, when you give him that praise.
Right.
It makes them do better. So it's almost like, even if you don't, it's just a little.
I'm starting to understand.
Yeah,
bro.
It ain't even.
I am. I'm starting to understand it. I'm going to try to get better, but I just come from a different era, bro.
I know, like, what you're saying. You just like, if I don't feel like, that shit,
nigga,
I don't even text like that, bro.
Yeah. I call a motherfucker and be like, hey, you know what I'm saying? What's up? Before I cut to tell you, I call that nigga. This nigga, yeah. Man, niggas be wanting to text and shit, bro.
Texas
for like, to me, like.
Go ahead, give it to him.
Yo, grab some milk while you at the store. That's what I text.
I'm not about
for.
To send
like,
a book up.
Right,
yeah.
I'm not about to have a whole conversation. Now, excuse me. What I will do is I'll be in the messages.
Uh-huh.
Like, and we have a whole conversation, you know, these barbers everywhere up and coming, and they would tell you, like, bro, yeah, he showed me mad love. He told me this, da da da. And I don't have no filter. I don't have no filter with them. It's like,
it's just, you got to keep it 100. That's going
to
help them grow.
You might need to get better here. You might need to, this is strong. You know what I'm saying? And I don't have all of the answers, bro. That's another thing. And I've been watching these industry educators and people like that. Online, and there is no one way, there's not two ways or three ways to do this shit or
no,
to run your business. Everybody got a different business platform.
Exactly, all of that shit.
Motherfuckers be on there like, you need to do this, and you need to, like, no, nigga, if you, no, like, me and you, we work out of suite.
Yeah.
We run our business totally different than somebody who's at the shop and take walk-ins. So some of that shit y'all talking do not apply to us or me.
Listen,
you know what I'm saying?
I don't even want to work it. Let's talk about this barbershop versus suites.
Mm-hmm.
The shop versus the suite.
Okay. Yeah.
Tell them, what are the benefits? I feel like it's more benefits with a suite.
Most definitely for me.
Yeah, for me too.
I'm introverted anyway. Like, I'm working on it.
Yeah, you know, I mean, like, you get more person with your client, and you ain't got to worry about, okay, this barber over here talking this. Do you know a lot of people feel like they don't even want to go that extra mile because they worry about who's watching it.
And in the shop, you feel it's some type of, it's a competition. Yeah. When that door swing and that bell ring, you on a client, and let's say you done watched two or three come in, and you like, shit, I gotta, you know, yeah. Niggas is getting the money. Like, when I'm up in there, I already got this client time set aside. We gonna chop it up for this 30, 45 mm-hmm. minutes. You know what I'm saying? You gonna feel comfortable, because you don't want to be there all day neither.
True, true.
But, you know what I'm saying? But you want to feel like you're getting your worth.
You
know what I'm saying?
Yes. You give an experience.
You know, and that's exactly. Where I was in a shop when I first got out of barber school. It taught me so much. Because I used to sit, I used to watch clients. You know when you hearing all that, seeing all that shit. Yeah. I'm like, I'm never going to do that. I'm never going to run my shit like that. You know what I'm saying? I watched dudes like, yeah, let me get him and him. Then I got you. And then they get him and him. Then they go get something to eat. Then they come. Then they talking on, like, man, I'm not doing none of that. When I'm at work, I don't answer my phone, bro. I don't answer texts, no nothing. Clients be, man, can you get me or not? Bro, I'm going to get to all of
that. First
of all,
I'm not about that. I might answer your phone because I got my headphones in. Mm-hmm. Now, a text, they might complain about a text. I'm not answering no texts because I can't see no text. I'm not about to stop my cut.
I don't stop.
No, I'm not doing that.
I don't stop. I agree with that. It's a certain first of all, this man is paying me generously. You know what I'm saying? There's a certain, like I said, there's certain standards I have for my clients and there's certain standards they have for me. You know what I'm saying? And I'm maintaining that. You know what I'm saying? You can ask any of my clients. They're never pulling up and I'm not there. If I'm not there, they calling 911. Like, that's how they is. They like, no, not
cause
him.
Because you always cutting, right?
Always. He's what never
they,
late.
What they say behind you?
No doubt.
You always cutting.
I'm always committed to. Mm-hmm. I'm committed to what the fuck I said I was going to do.
Always and cutting. You know always what I'm committed. Saying? I like that.
That's big, bro. Yeah, he's that's right. Like big in this business because clients ain't used to that. You done had clients come from other places and they're like, man, they not used to that, bro. Then yeah, they get spoiled too. I had some, you know, they leave and try to come back and all that because they realize like, damn, this shit ain't. I ain't getting this level of commitment nowhere else, man.
So don't you charge? You charge for people leaving and coming back. I want to say I seen you post something saying if you leave, it's almost like a reconnection fee.
That price might be different.
Yeah, there you go. Hey, yesterday's price is not today's. Today's price.
I'm an artist and I'm sensitive about my shit. Hey, you feel me?
That's real shit.
Your girl leave you.
You gotta work.
But it's that level. They don't understand that it's that. And people say don't get business with it, but it's that level of a relationship you have with these people. You know what I mean? That level of commitment. These people don't see. They definitely don't see what we going through behind the scenes. And it's our job not to let them see that. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? But they not seeing that we missing this. We missing this family time. We ain't ate all day. They ain't seeing none of this. They don't know what's going on with us, and we not really supposed to let them see that, but it's a level of commitment. You don't know what I didn't sacrifice.
That's why I charge what I charge for one, because it's like you're gonna get the quality.
Mm-hmm.
My thing is, I'm charging for my time.
Yeah, most definitely. I charge. I don't know if you do, but basically, I charge for an appointment, a time block, and it's that price. I don't care if you come in and say, "Man, get this one."
That's how I charge too.
Yeah.
Like, so when somebody might say, "Well, it's Sunday or it's Monday," I just want to edge. It's still $100.
Mm-hmm.
I don't care what you want. It's the time, because now I'm not about to let you walk out of here until I'm finished how I want you to be finished.
Mm-hmm. So, and my lineup gonna be different.
Exactly.
It's gonna be different.
Yeah. It's not.
Cause I'm putting in, yeah,
I'm putting that work in. Right. Exactly.
You
yeah.
basically getting a haircut, man.
Yeah,
you know what I'm saying?
Like, that's their way of trying to.
That's my. Yeah. That's my name going out there. Exactly. You know what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm. Heavy.
That's I got a sign
that's
in that.
That's my name.
That's heavy right there.
You know what I'm saying? Yeah.
You paying for the time,
but like I said, I'm really an introverted person, and my work. Has made me be more social, have to be more social and stuff like that. But I'm really, like, this is my element, so I'm more, I'm comfortable.
You about to be out. We about you to pull you saying? On out because we got this segment coming up. Y'all see me? This segment coming up with me, you, and Kuttz.
Oh, what?
Yeah. We gonna do that.
He gonna try to turn me up. He already know.
Oh yeah, we was already like, talking about that. We was already talking about that.
We go through these. You know, I'm a. I like to consider myself a historian or whatever. I just like to study what I'm doing. Like if
who was the first barber?
I was in a man. That this, me.
He said me. Man, cause he was in here talking about you. He was like, man, Kase know all the history of barber, and I said,
I believe like, let's say hip hop. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. I believe that you gotta study those before you. You gotta study
check
the
background,
game, bro.
Check the background.
Yeah, if that's what you doing, bro. Just like you did, yeah, like you said, you do comedy. Study everybody, bro. You study. You know, you want to know
black women, every race, any stand up that's out there.
Everything, anything that has to do with your craft, bro. Yeah. And then. You know this, it's too much to be learned, bro.
It's not a ceiling to it.
You ain't never stop learning. Nah, that's why I said I watch everybody, from students, the people who you think ain't, because they might be, bro, I might watch a trash video haircut, and they might do one thing, that I'd be like, damn, I need to put that in my arsenal.
I'm going to tell you this, it's some barbers out there got some names that's up. That they feel like it's like star barbers out here. And I'll be looking and I'll be like, man.
Because you're a student of the craft. See, that's the thing. I am blessed to be able to do what I love and practice my craft and make money monetarily, capitalize monetarily. But the craft is before everything. You know what I'm saying?
I mean, I feel the same way. What I'm saying is when I see that these...
With
these,
them, the craft isn't... Before everything, it's monetary, bro.
Yeah. So, I'm trying to figure out how do they get here when this part right here ain't there. Like, I ain't gonna put no names out there.
Marketing.
Yeah, yeah. It's
a squad behind pushing you.
Yeah.
A lot of these cats, they got a machine. Of these cats, people push them.
Yeah.
Out there.
Okay.
You know what I'm saying?
Okay.
I be like,
I know you be seeing some of the same people. Like,
give me. Put the bread up. Put these.
Oh, let's talk about that.
Put these chairs next to. You know what I'm saying? Like if it's, you know, I be feeling like that sometimes. Not that I'm even wanna. You know what I'm saying? But
put the bread up.
So what about the bread for the barbers that when it comes to these shows,
what about
they be charging? What are these numbers? What are these numbers to get some of these big names?
My cat. Unfortunately, the cats that I've been bringing in, it's been cool, you know, and I ain't never
have you ever heard anything outstanding?
Yes,
yeah, yeah,
super crazy. And I'm like, shit, how do I get in that lane? Like, you know, like, but you know, they're in a different lane,
yeah,
you know, yeah, they ain't that good, but they then work their way into Paul Mitchell, into you know what I mean, and these big companies. Pay different, but they not paying us.
You're right.
We the inventors. We're the curators of this craft, and I don't see enough of us. I can name a few of these companies. You know what I mean? I'll be like, you know, it's kind of like watching that TV show and that token nigga is up in there. Like you can tell that they placed up in there. Like, well, we got to get a black guy. You know what I'm saying? You know, bring a Latino in. They're hot right now. You know what I'm saying? And it's like, damn, bro. You know what I mean? But we the ones who going out buying that shit, hashtagging them. You would think, okay, put it this way. You got a company, right? Where is most of your money going? Most of your money goes into, number one, the actual product. Then another big bulk of the money goes into marketing.
Yeah.
But you tell me the last time you seen an Andy's commercial. You tell me the last time you seen a Wall commercial. You know why? Because we do it for them for free. And you would think, since they're...
That was a good one.
You would think...
Yeah, think about that.
you would think since they are having, they're gaining so much money from not having to market this product, that you would think the price would be fair. Yeah. Like, damn, we ain't got to kill them. Okay, we saving so much
on market. On these clippers.
But they just going up and up. You know why? Because you got niggas on there balling. They shaking the bottles. They barbers. So they like, oh, y'all niggas kicking it. Y'all making, okay, I see what car. You driving this car. Okay, take them up another $50. Take them up another $20.
They out here killing,
you know what I'm saying?
These clippers.
And I'm going to use what I need to use. I am not marketing none of them. None of it.
Have you noticed that that shit, like, it's to the point where it's starting at 200.
Yes.
Pretty much. Like, I mean.
Yes. And they don't have to market. And the people that they do got marketing, they say, here, thanks. Here, let me, all these brand ambassadors and all. Here goes free clipper. Try that out. It only cost us $2 in China. We're going to sell this motherfucker for $250. But go ahead. Here, you can have these. And they excited. I got the new. You know what I'm saying?
That shit, like, they done dropped that shit like Jordans.
Exactly. And they're using the same thing. They're same creating format. They're getting hype beasts.
Yeah.
Hype beasts to drive the prices up.
But for any, we have to realize, because I did marketing, for like sales and marketing. That's all I've done in my life. But these companies don't market for black people. Like, that's what we have to understand. Like,
yeah, I definitely said that.
Every company doesn't market for black people. They don't need to, because we live in. Kanye West said it best when I keep thinking of forgetting that song, but we get so caught up in things. That's all it is. Like a razor. I'm not, you know, I don't know nothing about barber, but I bet you the first razor shave came from a black man. I'm convinced of that, cause we didn't have shit.
Oh, it started then.
We didn't have
like
nothing.
A damn show.
We had zero. So
videos and
see me on cloud 50, big brim me, no light dim me till my soul empty. I give it all to the ones that I love, no letting go, I hold them tighter than the grudge. I need to see them, high hands mapping out these floor plans, rich dad, poor kid. Not again, we stop the cycle from a place where most cats is masked up like Michael Myers. It's a nightmare on Elm Street when they come to sleep, especially when your mama trying to make ends meet. You don't know that struggle, kid. Used to be that trouble, kid. Now I'm making everything happen cause I'm that humble, kid. Used to be that rumble, kid. Doing what I want. It was either get it or you don't. You don't know the hurt of your mama scrambling for change just to get to you for lunch.
Ooh, I just can't see the light where I'm standing. It's too many clouds. I just can't see the light where I'm standing. Oh,
I mean, we know where it came from.
It came from black people. So that's what we got to realize, is that marketing. And another thing is, and people have always hated me for this, I've sold advertisements to the community. We don't want to pay for anything. We don't. Black people do not want to pay for anything.
Well, I will say we don't want to pay for anything from Mr. Pringles. But we paying for it from.
That's what I'm saying. Yeah.
Yeah. We paying for it from him.
Well, they want the steak. They want the steak in a microwave. And that's like you
what,
said.
That's what they doing, bro. You know what I mean? And they killing us, bro. They killing us, bro.
Man, this shit gets out of hand.
Like
now.
I said, shout out Jermaine Walker, Morano. Get him a hand clap, bro. All them brothers.
Yeah, for sure, for
everybody.
Sure.
Doc McNeely. There it is.
Doc McNeely. I got to follow him. I ain't following him.
Yeah, Doc McNeely. And everybody else. What's the other girl? She could too. Everybody out there making. you know, branding your own blades, any of that, anything that you're doing, man, shout out to y'all, and I'm going to purchase it if I need it. You know what I mean?
But I got a shirt.
I'm going to support it.
I got a shirt. I follow a company called Bearded Brother. I did it last time. Yeah, like, they give me a shirt for when I perform. Mm-hmm. It's a young lady. She's killing.
We have to do all of that, bro, because they are shutting us out. They are shutting us out, bro. They taking this industry and they snatching it away from us for the longest. I mean,
you know who make Babblers?
Yes.
I just found that shit out yesterday. I didn't know that.
Yes, they make beautiful products, but I mean, if you want me to be perfectly honest, a lot of it's trash.
Do you know who? Con Air. That shit crazy. That was the Clippers that we started with.
We can go to CVS right now, and they got them stacked up in there. You know what I'm saying? But that's why I said, the way they're going up on all of these prices for all of this equipment and things like that. Think of a master, right? That same master is running out. Actually, that's how I started. My grandfather was a barber. He was dead before I was born. But my father still had his clippers. He had hundreds of pairs of clippers still. Okay. And I just got in the garage, fucking with them, changing cords, blowing sockets, everything. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? But those clippers still worked after all of these years. Now we go spend $250-$300 on these clippers, and they last a couple of nights. Yeah, all type of stuff. Even the corded ones. You know what I mean? The appearance of them is shinier, but the quality is going down, and the price is going up. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? And we still.
I got the new. Let me unbox it, man.
Not case.
So my question is this. What we going to do as far as the Clippers? Like, is there a black-owned Clipper coming? We can do a lot of talking.
All they doing is, man, you got China. Like I said, shout out Morano. He a cold motherfucker, man. Morano is cold. Cold-blooded, man. Y'all ain't see. Morano, like, what was... Jay-Z and
you talking about Streets is Watching?
No, that wasn't Jay-Z. That was Denzel Washington in that one movie where he was gangster.
American Gangster. Oh, when he played Frank Lucas.
Morano is Frank Lucas, bro. He goes straight to the source, bro. He going straight to the people who make it. He cold-blooded, bro. Know what I'm saying? And that's all they doing. They're going over there. You go to trade shows. They might have 50 clippers laying down. You turning them on and you say, okay, I want these. And they have MOQs, minimum order quantity. You might have to get 50,000 of them. But I want these, put my name on it. They say you can customize and put your name on it how you want to, whatever color, da 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 da. Know what I'm saying? And that's about. And it's not hard.
You ain't even got to go nowhere.
It's marketing, and you have to have the capital. If we got the co-op together, we say everybody put in da 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 da, and we coming out because that's what Tune 45 do.
Right, and that's what I was getting at from the beginning.
That's what they do.
Exactly.
You know what I'm saying? That's what all what they doing, man. Them damn spray guns, all that shit. Man, put our name on these, bro. Yeah. Stamp it. Boom.
That mat, you know that damn, that charger mat.
Put our name on it.
Oh, and that's what it was.
Yeah. Know what I mean? It's some companies that, you know, some people, they actually go to an actual chemist and get their products developed. Yeah. And they might already have the base of the product, but you might say, I want my shit red and I want it to smell like this. They throw that up in there and let you try it, and next thing you know, boom, they done came up with the packaging, your name on it, and then, you know what I mean? And some companies already have it pre-made, everything, and they just say, we gonna put your name on it, and now you got your own product. You know what I'm saying? So, it's very few people at home mixing all this shit, because I've done that just as a tester and to put stuff out there and to see how it goes, but what if it get hot? What if it get shit? How you gonna keep up with the man?
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Right. So you have to step up to a bigger company. You know what I mean? To have a team. Even with the show, we can do what all them doing. Right here. We can do what all them
Columbus
doing.
But
I need help. I need help to grow it. I realize.
We could. You know what? We got to change that.
We
shit.
Can.
We will.
Okay. Okay.
Yeah.
I'm feeling that.
We will.
I'm feeling that.
We will. Yeah. Definitely. Yeah. We will. It's going down.
But, yeah. We definitely will be bigger, big ass, big all of that. You know what I'm saying? But I couldn't.
You can't do it by yourself.
I couldn't do it by myself. Yeah. And I understood that. Like, damn. Like, I can only go so far by myself. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? And
That's a good way to...
I mean...
I like that.
You got people who want to work with you and some who don't. But shit, I ain't done nothing to nobody. Do nothing but
they all want to work with you, but we talked about it earlier.
I ain't done nothing but make my couple of dollars. And
you the first one to do it.
I ain't done nothing to nobody.
Yeah.
And that's the thing. I tell people just like the show. I'm like... Come to the show, bro. I'm not about to miss out on something that could be valuable to me or help me grow because I don't like somebody. You know what I'm saying? Or, you know.
It's trillions of people in the world. Trillions of niggas. Trillions of bitches in this fucking world. You got 200 clients. I'm just giving a number of people. There are 200 different fucking people. Uh-huh. There's 200 different fucking people. Why are people upset? It's too, like, every barber has different people.
It's like green beans in the fucking grocery store. It's a whole bunch of different fucking brands.
Oh, my God. And they're coming up every day.
Yeah, it don't stop.
I'm going to put them on alert, bro. When I do something, when we do something, it's going to be official. It's
going
to be.
It's going down.
It's going to be thorough. I'm putting y'all on alert right now. You know what I'm saying?
Man, what the business is, man.
It's going to be thorough. I know I ain't going to play with it. And people I'm surrounding, we ain't going to play with it, man. So.
It's going down.
Just be ready. You know what I'm saying?
And that's how we going to go ahead and get up out of here. This is what we're going to do is the last thing. What advice do you have for up and coming barbers right now? The first thing. What's the main thing that you would like to tell somebody as an up and coming barber?
This one been on my mind for a minute, and I've been telling everybody just in life, don't let anyone or anything make you feel as though what you're doing isn't enough.
That's heavy.
You know what I'm saying?
That's heavy.
I mean. We all going to be tough on ourselves. But it ain't nobody out here, bro. It ain't nobody I see on the internet doing nothing, driving this, doing that, and make me feel like what I'm working towards isn't enough or I can't get there or I can't, you know what I mean? Don't let nobody ever make you feel like that. We all start somewhere with anything we do, not just barbering. You know what I'm saying? But before we get out of here, too, I want to dedicate this to... my guy, Benji.
Benji.
You know what I'm saying? He died earlier this year. And that's my brother, man. And, you know,
condolences.
I was glad I was there. He got killed. But, you know, let me tell you about Benji, man. This is the, you know how you meet some people in life and they not, your blood, but they
your blood
do more than your blood could have ever done, man.
Mm-hmm.
I'm talking about, bro, I met dude when I was in barber school, bro. Dude made me believe in myself. Like, you know, he helped create Kase Kuttz, bro. You know, when I was in barber school, he was coming through that motherfucker paying me $200. Know what I mean? 300. Man, you couldn't tell him nothing. You couldn't tell him that I wasn't the best in the world, bro. Support me. You know what I mean? This was a guy, best client, one of the best client, well, the best client I've ever had, and one of the best friends, you know what I mean? Brothers I've ever had in my life, you know what I mean? This dude just stopped by, man. You eat breakfast yet, bro? Just stop off, drop.
Oh,
yeah, and you ain't
solid,
even got no appointment,
yeah,
you know what I mean? You ain't even got no appointment. Just, here, man, here go breakfast, bro. I know you, you know what I mean? I ain't asked for this. I ain't want, but it was just, that sense of, you know what I mean? I miss my bro. You know what I'm saying? But
shout out to Benji, man.
Get this one at Benji, man. Yeah, beat Benjamin, bro. Yeah.
Shout out to Benji, man.
You know what I'm saying? Yes, sir. It's my guy, man.
Well, we about to get up out of here, man. Hey, man, make sure y'all go follow Kase Kuttz. Hey, Teddy.
Catch a case.
Catch a case. Yeah. You know what? It's catch a case.
Yeah.
Now listen to this. See, Kuttz was on here the other time, and I said catch a case. Uh-huh. And Kuttz said Kase Kuttz. Uh-huh. So I thought I was tripping for a second.
That's my Instagram.
Your Instagram is
case,
what?
It's Kase Kuttz. Catch a case.
It's catch a case. I thought it was catch a case.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, I know.
That came from that.
I know where that came
somebody
from.
Gave me that in there. I just ran with it. Okay.
Yeah, that worked. That worked. But yeah, man, go ahead and follow Catch a Case on Instagram.
I can't even do it.
Hey, yeah. No, he's about to do it in just a second, but hey Teddy the comedian, man. Follow Teddy, man. You know, Teddy gonna keep you laughing at all times, man. Teddy off the fucking chain, man. But yeah, man, you know in the building, man, go one time for him, Case.
Y'all already know what it is, man. Kase Kuttz, Catch a Case, Cocky Case, Justin Case. Kase Axelrod. Kase.
There you go, right there, man. There you go. Right there. Hey, we up out of here, man. Yeah. It's Mr. Pringles the Barber, aka Alwayzkuttn's head honcho. I am him, not them.